I am, Mr. Tarrou. We just got done talking about finding the sum, the infinite sum of a geometric series. We're going to use that concept now to revisit an idea that you might have learned many, many years ago where you converted repeating decimals into fractions. When you're first learning these ideas, I don't know if that's late grade school or middle school, but hopefully now that we understand what a geometric series is and why we're able to find an infinite sum, we can revisit this and make it, you know, actually understand why it's working. So we want to convert 0.4 repeating into a decimal. Well, 0.4 repeating is 0.444, you know, and so on. So we're going to take this repeating decimal and expand it. So it's going to be 0.04 plus the first place is 0.4. So 0.4 plus 0.04, that's for the second 4 in the hundredths place, plus 0.004 plus and so on. So I'm taking this repeating decimal and I'm expanding it to a long series of additions. Now I'm going to write each of these in fraction form just to really build in that idea of geometrics, that this is a geometric series. So this is the tenths place, so this is 4 tenths plus, this is the hundredths place, so 4 one hundredths plus thousandths place, so 4 over 1,000, and again, so on and so on. Now this would be our a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, going on to a sub infinity, basically. And if you look in between each of these terms, the denominator is getting bigger by a multiple of 10, and the denominator is staying, or the numerator, excuse me, is staying the same. So that means our r value is equal to 1/10. So we have an a sub 1 value of 4/10, we have an r value of 1/10, and, you know, let's find that infinite sum out, shall we? So the sum is equal to a sub 1, I'm going to reduce this as well, they're both even. So a sub 1 is going to be 2 over 5 over 1 minus r, or 1/10. We need common denominators here, so that's going to be, instead of 1, it's going to be 10 over 10. So we have 2/5. 10 over 10 minus 1 over 10 is 9/10. We're going to flip that bottom fraction up to do the division of the fractions and get 10 over 9. And what happens? Well, 5 and the 10 cancel out, giving us 1 and 2. And our final answer is 2 times 2 is 4 ninths. So if you go to your calculator and you do 4 divided by 9, guess what you get? 0.4 repeated. And I was a little bit tight on space here, so let me erase this so I have more room for my next example. Okay, this example is going to work out very similar to the first one, except I'm repeating two decimals instead of just one. So when we expand this out, we're going to get a piece of white chalk, here we go, and get 0.23, that's for the first two, plus now two zeros, because we just took care of those first that first 23, so 0.0023. And that's for these two here, and then expand it again if you'd like, 0.000023, and so on and so on and so on. Again, let's put those into fraction form. This is the hundredths place, so that's going to be 23 over 100. Tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 10,000ths place, so this is going to be 23 over 10,000, and so on, and so on and so on. So we have again an a sub 1 value of 23 over 100, and we have an r value of 1 over, because the top is staying the same, and we're going from 100 to 10,000. We added two zeros, we multiplied by 100 in the denominator. So this infinite sum, this geometric series has an infinite sum of s, is equal to a sub 1 over 1 minus r. That's going to be equal to 23 So that's 23 over 100. Hello. So 23 over 100 over, let's see, comp denominator, right? So we have 100 over 100. I'm kind of off the screen there, aren't I? That's going to be 100 minus 1, which is 99 over 100. And here we have the exact same denominator. So when I flip the bottom up, all that's going to happen is our common denominators of 100 are going to cancel out, and we end up with 23 over 99. Let me check my work. And yes, so 23 divided by 99 is going to be 0.23, repeating in your calculator. So that is how you turn a repeating decimal into a fraction, and why that process worked that maybe you were taught in an earlier, much earlier math class. Because it's an infinite sum of a geometric series. Now our last example is just a tiny bit different, and it's enough difference though to really throw off some students, and that's the fact that not all of the decimals are repeating. Here we have 0.2 and then the 1.3 repeats, but not the other values. So when we expand this, we're going to have 0.2 plus, now there's a 0, we already took care of the 2, so now it's going to be plus 0.013 plus, okay, now I took care of this one, this one, this one. So I need 3 zeros, 0.000, and now I got 1.3. And then I can continue this process again if I wanted to write 5 zeros and run out of space on the chalkboard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so on and so on and so on. I'm out of space. Well, this is going to give me, and I'm going to run out of space here, so let me bring this over here. This is going to give me 2 over 10. So 2 tenths plus, that's 0.013. Now 3 is in the tenths, hundredths, thousandths place. So we have 13 over 1,000. Let's try that again. 10, 100,000. Just want to make sure. Plus our next fraction, tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, hundred thousandths place. So we're 13 over 100,000. And so on and so on and so on. This is what we're paying attention to because it's the point, or it's the 1.3 that's repeating. So we have a ratio of going from 1,000 to 100,000 that we multiply by 1 over 100. So our common, our R value, our common ratio is 1 over 100. And this is our A sub 1 value right there. Now I'm going to kind of put the 2 over 10 or the 1/5 on the back burner because that is not repeating. It's everything else that is. And that's why this is going to be marked off as A sub 1. Okay, so we have the infinite sum is equal to A sub 1. So that's going to be 13 over 1,000 divided by 1 minus R, which is going to be, well, of course, R is 1 over 100, common denominator. That's instead of 1 going to be 100 over 100, and 100 minus 1 is 99. So we get 13 over 1,000 over 99 over 100. Let's go ahead and flip that bottom up because now the entire denominators are not going to cancel like the last example. And we get 13 over 1,000 times 100 over 99, and the 100 is going to cancel out two of our zeros in the denominator. So we've got to now go back and pay attention to the non-repeating part of this problem, which is 2/10. So our final fraction is going to be the combination of 13 over 990 That takes care of the 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3 that started at the hundredths place. So we have to take a look at 2 over 10, bringing this down, plus the fraction that we got from the repeating part of the decimal, 13 over 990. We need a common denominator, so we're going to multiply this first fraction by, let's see, how about 990 on the top and bottom? Or 99, I mean, excuse me. I'm thinking of the common denominator. And we get, just to make sure I don't write the wrong answer here, we get 198. That's from doing 99 times 2. I should have just done that in my head. 100 times 2 is 200 minus 2 is 198 plus 13 over our common denominator of 990. And we get 211 over 990. And that is 3 examples of how to turn a repeating decimal into a fraction, and actually, maybe unlike the younger grade where you learned this, you understand why. So I'm Mr. Chiru. Bam! Go do your homework.